What is up, ladies and gentlemen? Make some noise for me. Let me know how you are feeling tonight. Oh, you all are far too kind. Thank you all so, so much for coming out. My name is Matt DeCourt. I will be your ring announcer this evening as tonight, Test of Strength proudly presents Lone Survivor 5! I love that energy, everybody, and I want you to keep that energy up all night long, because not only do we have championship matches up and down the card, not only do we have the Lone Survivor elimination match for number one contendership, but your main event will be Ichiban, the K-1 Classic champion, taking on the Underground King, the Test of Strength champion, in a champion versus champion match. All the gold is on the line. So what do you say, everybody? You've all been very patient. Are you ready to see some wrestling? Yeah. Are you ready to start Lone Survivor 5? Yeah. Our opening contest is a singles match scheduled for one fall. And it is for the Test of Strength Women's Championship.
Ladies and gentlemen, hello and welcome to Test of Strength Wrestling's Lone Survivor 5. My name is Drew Kazoo, coming at you live and direct from Warehouse 635 in beautiful West Hartford, Connecticut, and we are kicking this one off with our hands, ladies and gentlemen, women's title on the line.
Throw it back, hype that beat up.
We await the arrival now.
Girl, hype that beat up. You can hold a girl in, hype that beat up.
Karen Bam Bam.
Hey, she thick, yeah. She go hard, but can she do it? I'm the nick, yeah. Hey, she bad, yeah. Hey, she thick, yeah. She go hard, but can she do it? I'm the nick, yeah. I don't want your roll ups if it's light as
sweet.
I'm tryna cut like I got a knife or something. So good, she could be my wife or something. So
bad,
I'm tryna hit it twice or something. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
What's
it
back?
I'ma throw these racks, yeah, yeah, yeah. Drop it down, make
many believe to be
yeah, yeah, yeah. Your manager, I hit it while he gone. Yeah, yeah, yeah. When he get out, I'ma move around. Yeah, yeah. Boys hatin', but it ain't gon' help.
I'm talking down,
but she wanna see for herself. Pull it up
on this historic occasion.
Smash.
Lone Survivor 5, of course. As we await the arrival now.
Don't call me an angel. As long as they sit
back. Of the very first TOS Women's Champion.
Introducing first, the challenger, hailing from the Bronx, New York, she represents the Mission, and she is the hottest and heaviest woman in the world, Mount Bay, Karen Bam Bam Renee. And her opponent, she hails from Puerto Rico and weighed in at 125 pounds of pure muscle. She is the reigning, defending, defending Test of Strength Women's Champion, Evie De La Rosa.
Listen to that ovation, ladies and gentlemen. I got to tell you, it feels good to hear that. Finally free from the mental clutches of Dan the Man and the Mission, Evie De La Rosa, once again a fan favorite, and she has got her work cut out for her tonight. Look at the look on Karen Bam Bam Renee's face, taking her time, making her way to the middle of the ring. Go. All we need is that bell. We're ready to rock, ladies and gentlemen.
All you stop is need to grow up and get with the program.
Wow. Tell us how you really feel. Oh, here we go. Starting this one off ugly. There we go. Big right hand by the champion. Looks like I missed the bell. I was so excited about this whole thing. Here we go. Evie hard into the corner. Oh boy, choice words. Evie out of the way. Shoulder block right to the midsection. Up and over, we get a sunset flip. No. Oh, look at that. Ooh, wow. Flush with that knee, right to the chin of Karen Bam Bam, making her way to the top rope now. Oh, looks like she was coming out for a double axe handle, caught. Oh my goodness. Wow, Evie De La Rosa hard to the mat with authority now as she just gets stomped right in the midsection by that big boot of Renee. Sold out indeed. Shocked is not the word to describe how I and the TOS faithful felt seeing Karen Renee joining forces with her, at the time, her arch nemesis, Dan the Man. Long history between her and Danos. Last thing anyone ever expected was to see her join the Mission following the teachings of the Book of Danos. But we were all... Hang on, big right hand there by Evie. Big drop kick to the midsection. Sends Renee into the ropes. Went for the Irish whip, no dice. Bam Bam hangs on. Reversal. Evie into the ropes. Oh, look at that. Not sure what Evie was going for, but Karen Bam Bam with a drop kick of her own to the midsection of Evie De La Rosa. You know, you gotta think, Dan the Man knows both of these women as well as any. He's done battle with both for years, and he knows the ins and outs of each one of these competitors, so you know that he had some insight for Karen Bam Bam to share all those secrets. So Bam Bam may be one step ahead of Evie De La Rosa tonight. Evie with the heavy lumber, two hard forearm shots in the corner. Still feeling that effects of that drop kick. Avalanche into the corner, going for another one. Gets the second, no! Bam Bam caught her in midair, look at this. Bear hug right in the middle of the ring. Oh, my goodness. And this here is a nasty, nasty predicament for the TOS Women's Champion. Just getting the life squeezed right out of her. Trying to fight back, dropping those right hands to no avail. Trying to get that left arm around the head. She does. She frees herself. Got the champ into the rope. Finally, Evie free from the clutches of Karen Bam Bam Renee. Of course, Evie had some very choice words for Karen Bam Bam. You know, she admitted she's done some questionable things there at TOS, but regardless, she's always told the truth. She's always let the fans know her true intentions. Oh, squish granted right in the middle of the ring. This is going to be it, ladies and gentlemen. We got a new champion. New champion. No. Evie still with the wherewithal to kick out. But she is in a world of hurt after receiving that squish granted right in the middle of the ring. So again, Evie always been honest with the fans no matter where she stood, but she says Karen Bam Bam, like a snake, faked her way into the fans' hearts, and the minute she realized she wasn't going to get that TOS women's title, she switched and joined who she calls her knight in plastic armor, being Danos. Look at this. Those clotheslines and those shoulder tackles having no effect on Karen Bam Bam. Going for a once again, this time it worked. Renee hard to the mat, and this is Evie's chance. Goes for the cover. No, not enough. Evie gaining control in this match, but undoubtedly still reeling from that squish granted right in the middle of the ring. Oh, she's calling for the full throttle. Here we go. No. Huge right hand. No. Evie looking for that to set Karen Renee up for that full throttle. Wasn't able to get it. And Bam Bam wisely now. Rolling to the ups, calling for that timeout. You know what I'm going to say. No timeouts in wrestling, ma'am. Evie's going to remind you of that. Big handful of hair trying to get Karen Renee back in the ring. Oh, my goodness. Bam Bam is biting Evie De La Rosa. I can't believe those words came out of my mouth. Unbelievable. Undoubtedly, teachings written in the book of Danos. We're seeing a whole new, a whole different Karen Renee tonight. What is this? Setting her up. Perched on the ropes there. Oof. Snapmare takes the champion down. Oh. Using her assets to her advantage. Going for squish granted again. No, this time. Evie out of the way. Going for the DDT. No, once again stopped. Once again caught in midair now. Hold on. Karen Renee. Oh, and there it is, a big DDT. Oh, wasn't able to get over there for the cover. Once again, Karen Bam Bam rolls to the outside. Of course, congratulations to the champion for winning 2023 Women Wrestler of the Year. Evie now up on the top rope, but quickly taken down by that right hand. She is going to use every second of that count of five to try to drain the life out of Evie. Look at the grimace on the face of our champion. There she goes once again, perched on that second rope. Oh, and a big elbow. No. A lot of new offensive maneuvers here in the arsenal of Karen Renee Bam Bam. Excuse me, Karen Bam Bam Renee. Well, she's got the underhooks here. What's she setting her up for? Tiger suplex, perhaps? Oh, just dumped face first, hard to the mat. Oh, and there's a boot. Evie trying to create some separation between her and Bam Bam. Oh, my goodness. Club and shot. Evie's taking a lot of damage. Ah, and these two now trading shots right in the middle of the ring. Evie getting the upper hand. Or so I thought. Clubbing. Right forearm. Sends Evie hard to the mat. You can hear the TOS faithful rallying behind their women's champion, but will it be enough? Once again, she's got Evie up. Oh, look at this. Evie rolls her up. She got her! Wow, just like
ladies
that.
And gentlemen, here is your winner, and still Test of Strength Women's Champion, Evie De La Rosa!
Wow, ladies and gentlemen, just what it looked like. Karen Bam Bam was on the cusp of becoming TOS Women's Champion in a snap of a finger, no pun intended. Evie De La Rosa with the quick roll-up and gets Karen Bam Bam for the 1-2-3. Still your TOS Women's Champion, Evie De La Rosa. What an opening contest here, ladies and gentlemen. We've got a whole lot more action coming your way. Don't forget, title for title, champion versus champion here tonight. Underground King will be taking on Ichiban. Tag team titles on the line. Miracle Generation taking on Counter-Strike. And, of course, the lone survivor match itself. Six-man elimination for that number one contendership. Whole lot in store for you folks. I'm liking this Warehouse 635 too, man. Cool venue. And great to be back here in TOS.
All right, everybody. How was that for a start to Lone Survivor 5? Come on, I think you got a little bit more than that. How was that for a start to Lone Survivor 5? Now you're ready for the next one. The following contest is a tag team match scheduled for one fall.
All right, tag team action on the way here, ladies and gentlemen. Love me a little Ricky and Robert. Let's do this.
I reminisce for a spell, or shall I say think back 22 years ago to keep it on track.
Introducing the first team, now making their way to the ring, hailing from fresh out of your mama's freezer. Wow. Weighing in at a combined weight of 530 pounds, they are the dreaded icon Corey Jackson and the frozen one Don Freeze, Frozen Solid.
Oh, look who they have with them. Jesus. We're going to have to deal with Jared Silberkleit here tonight. You know he's going to grab the mic. You know he's got something to say. I'd be shocked if he doesn't. Well, Don Freeze, Corey Jackson must be trust fund approved.
And their opponents.
your women's phone. And I want to know what Dawn Freeze is doing in my mom's freezer. So we got Guapo Suave taking on Frozen.
Hey, wait. Hold the phone here. Hold the phone.
Yeah. Yeah, shut up, Jared. I mean, unless you're going to give us some money, obviously.
Okay, so you two guys call yourselves Guapo Suave. I could not think of a more ill-fitting tag team name. Look at you and look at the trust fund. Who do you think deserves to call themselves Guapo? You know, it's because of reactions like that that I suggest the two of you pick a name that better represents the town of West Hartford. Basura!
Oh, come on.
And get some Suave soap because you two stink!
It's okay. Well, you know Silver Clyde wouldn't be saying those things if he didn't have Frozen Solid to hide behind. He wants to know who deserves to be called Guapo Suave more. It's Alvarez and Lozano. It says it right on their shirts. There's the bell, and we are underway, ladies and gentlemen. We got Lex Lozano starting it off with Dawn Freeze. Are we going to freeze? No, crowd not into it. Hey, here we go. Looks like the crowd here. Oh. Yeah. Not a one, Silver Clyde, not a one. I will tell you, though, the incentive now for Dawn Freeze and Corey Jackson, the team of Frozen Solid, to win this contest has got to be great. They know there's a huge payday at the end of it. From Jared Silverclay. Here we go, two big men lock up. Look at the strength on full display. Look at the physique of Lex Lozano. Doesn't miss too many days in the gym, this young man. Again, Bell Time Club trained, sister school to test his strength. AKA number one dojo. All right, these two big men collide in the middle of the ring here. Freeze off the ropes. Once again, Lozano holding his own. Feel a little look of discouragement on the face of Dawn Freeze now. Oh, wow. And Freeze hard to the mat. Much to the delight of the TOS faithful here. I gotta tell you, it didn't really go the way that he wanted, but I am impressed with the speed on full display of the big man, Dawn Freeze. Listen to the crowd tell him, get a refund. Still a little early in the contest for that, folks. And here we get our first look at Corey Jackson, as well as our first look at Diego Alvarez. Oh, look at that. Thought he was going to get the lock up. Nope. He took a boot right to the breadbasket. And now it's Jackson on the attack. Ooh. Ugh. You know, you see those on TV, and they definitely look painful, but there's nothing like seeing and hearing them live and in person. There's a tag. Lozano back in. Oh, wow, look at that. Beautifully done. Oh, and a big boot for Dawn Freeze.
Guapo Suave feeling it right now. Jackson down, right in the middle of the ring here. Hey, double elbow drop. And Guapo Suave looking like a million bucks right now. And I like this, quick tags. Backbreaker. Here comes Alvarez. Round and round he goes off the ropes. Oh, wait a minute. Don Freeze with the leg pulls Alvarez outside, and just like that, the momentum switches. And Lozano hard to the outside. Jackson. Body slam Alvarez right in the middle of the ring. Oh, and just drops the knee right across the chin of Diego. Just realize if you folks at home, you get a drinking game for how many times I say right in the middle of the ring. You'd be hammered right now. Jackson up. Oh, look at that stalling suplex. No, Alvarez almost out of it, but no dice. Tag in to Freeze. Told you, I'm really surprised at the athleticism and the speed of this big man here. Hey. Alvarez fighting back now. Two uppercuts, a third one. Off the ropes. Oh, man. Huge clothesline. Sends Diego Alvarez hard to the mat. Hang on. No, count of two only. Lozano in there to make the save. Frozen solid on the attack now. Alvarez into the corner. Ooh, shoulder tackle. And another one. Wow, look at this. Very impressive. Beautiful snap suplex. No, count of two only. Silverplay thought that was it. What do we got now? Freeze. Wow, look at that. Beautiful standing moonsault right in the middle of the ring, but not enough. He tells us again, watch this. Yep, we're watching, pal. No. Went for the springboard moonsault. Nobody home. Can Alvarez make it to the corner? Can he make the tag to Lex Lozano? Crowd chanting Guapo firmly behind this young team. Freeze makes the tag. Here comes Jackson. No. Hang on. Diego's free. And here comes Big Lex. Clothesline. One for Jackson. One for Freeze. Lozano is a house on fire, ladies and gentlemen. Irish whip. Wow, look at this. Two huge leg lariats. Avalanche in the corner. It looked like he was going for another avalanche, turned into a knee right to the ribs there of Corey Jackson. And it is all Guapo Suave right now. Hang on, Silver Klein up on the apron. Don't worry about him, guys. Come on, don't let him distract you. We all want to see it, but watch out. Oh, look at this. Guapo Suave out of the way, and Jackson inadvertently hitting Jared Silberkleit, much to the delight of the TOS faithful. Hang on. Backbreaker. Off the ropes. Huge knee. That's going to be it, ladies and gentlemen. It is.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are your winners, Papi Guapo, Diego Alvarez, Leroy, Lex Lozano, Guapo Suave!
Wow, awesome match, ladies and gentlemen, and a huge win for this young team of Guapo Suave. Impressive showing by Frozen Solid, but you gotta thank Jared Silverclite. He's not happy about this. Right now, admonishing Freeze and Jackson. Uh-oh. Trouble in paradise, folks. All right, well, congratulations to Guapo Suave on their first victory here in TOS. Let's see if it's the first of many. Love to have them back. All right, Lone Survivor 5. We're just still getting started here, ladies and gentlemen. Still got the tag team titles on the line. Miracle Generation defending against Counter-Strike. And, of course, champion versus champion, Underground King and Ichiban.
All right, everyone. Real quick, just want to thank our friends, partners that are out here tonight. Big thank you to Pure Vanguard Wrestling. Want to give a shout-out to Headlocks for Humanity as well. And don't forget about the after party coming up later after the conclusion of Lone Survivor 5. That is taking place right nearby at Americana. And we've got a deal going on at the HS Apparel booth. $10 tees and beanies and $30 hoodies. So don't be shy and step on up to the HS Apparel booth. And also don't be shy, check out your favorite Test of Strength Stars merchandise booths that are all around the arena. Grab a t-shirt, grab an 8x10. If they're out and about, grab an autograph, a photo. They'll make sure you go home happy with a great memento from the night here at Test of Strength Lone Survivor 5. And now, our next contest is a singles match scheduled for one fall.
Hi, Papi.
Now making his way to the ring, accompanied by the Magic Man, hailing from straight out of your girlfriend's bedroom, weighing in at 180 pounds, he is Pretty Papi.
All right, well, they say God don't like ugly, but he likes this guy because he's pretty. With the Magic
and
Man.
His opponent.
Wait. Showstop.
Now approaching the ring, hailing from Queens, New York. Weighing at 210 pounds. Showstop. This is the special.
MMA, martial arts background. Oh, listen to that crowd. Ugly Papi. All right, there's the bell, and we are off, ladies and gentlemen. Contrast of styles here. as we've got the MMA martial arts style of Georgio Lawrence against the amateur wrestling style and the rugged ground and pound style of Pretty Papi. Collar and elbow tie up. Lawrence with the go behind, but Papi quickly gets control of the wrist. I'll tell you, underneath the whole exterior of, you know, Pretty Papi, the ladies' man, the roses, that is a quite an accomplished and talented professional wrestler, amateur wrestling background. Coaches youth wrestling. And when it comes to this business of professional wrestling, very few have paid the dues, grinded, put in the hard work that this young man has put in. It just so happens that if he feels like it, he will steal your girl. And look at this, educated feet on full display here at Georgio Lawrence. Wow, Papi wisely rolling to the outside. Lawrence, 6 feet, 200 pounds from Queens. Trained at NYCW by Mike Mondo. He's here tonight looking for a big win at Lone Survivor 5. Oh my goodness, you've got to be kidding me. Look at this, ladies and gentlemen. High impact with the knee. And then that shotgun dropkick sends Papi hard to the mat. Got him in the corner, no. Up and over, Papi going for the right hand. And here's the magic man trying to get himself involved. Oh, look at that, referee didn't see it. Magic man just slammed Georgio Lawrence's head hard on the ring apron there. And now Papi on the attack. Count of one only. And look at Pretty Papi, not a hair out of place. Unbelievable. Clubbing forearm to the back of the specialist. Lawrence now hard into the corner. He put all of his strength, all of his weight into that. Wow. Using the ropes to his advantage. Hold on. No, count of two only. No doubt, Pretty Papi trying to wear Georgio Lawrence down enough for him to get that anaconda vice on, which he likes to use to finish his matches. And if he gets that on, it's over for the specialist. This young man, Papi, moved down to Georgia to train at the Nightmare Factory under the tutelage of Cody Rhodes and QT Marshall. And of course, making his way up here to Connecticut as a student of the great Test of Strength School, number one dojo. Count of two only, look at this. Frustration setting in. Papi admonishing the referee for what he called a slow count. I don't know about that. Papi now. Looks like he's going for the suplex. No, blocked by the specialist. Up, inside cradle. No. Wow. Clothesline with authority. Still not enough to keep the specialist down. Oh, and Papi now. He's got that knee dug right into the back, wrenching those arms back. Oh, and look at this. Now he's got a handful of face. Crowd now trying to rally behind the specialist. Up to his feet. Trying to get some separation with those shots of the breadbasket to no avail. Lawrence escapes the body slam. Oh, look at this. Once again, that martial arts background of his coming into play here in this match. And once again, a huge knee strike. DDT! He got all of it. Papi wisely rolled to that, his magic man again. Wish somebody would make him disappear. Wow! Spine buster with authority. But still, not enough to get a victory here. I'm not sure what's going on. He's asking the magic man for something. What do we got? Hang on, referee can't see it. And look at this, Papi. He's got that crystal ball. He pulled that out of the magic man's box. Oh, look at that, Lawrence out of the way. And instead it was the magic man that got hit with it. Lawrence waiting in the wings, went for that tornado kick. Didn't get it, but he got it that time. Tornado kick by Georgio Lawrence. Rear naked choke. We've seen him put many an opponent away with this very move, but will it be enough to defeat Pretty Papi here tonight? He's got it locked in, ladies and gentlemen. Is this the beginning of the end for Pretty Papi? It is! Wow, what a match.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this match, the specialist, Georgio Lawrence!
Wow, what an action-packed contest that was, ladies and gentlemen. But in the end, it was the specialist, Georgio Lawrence. Besting Pretty Papi here against all the efforts of the magic man on the outside trying to interject himself into this match with the crystal balls and the rabbits out of hats and whatever else they're pulling out. Wasn't enough. Your winner tonight, the specialist, Georgio Lawrence.
Showstop. Showstop.
Showstop.
Showstop.
Showstop.
Showstop. Showstop. Wait. Fuck being conscious, money and profit.
Matt, new suit, Matt? Looking good tonight, brother.
All right, everybody still having a good time at Lone Survivor 5? All right, that is very good to hear. And if you like what you're seeing here tonight, just a quick reminder, take out your phones real quick, make a note, set a reminder, mark your calendars. Sunday, April 14th, 1 p.m. at the TOS Dojo. It is training day 47. So once again, we'll be back next month for another exciting training day. Training day 47, Sunday, April 14th. And then the following month in May, we will proudly present Dear Norma 4. And once again, that takes place on a Wednesday. It is Wednesday, May 22nd at 6 p.m. at Dudleytown Brewing Company in Windsor, Connecticut. Once again, Dear Norma 4, Wednesday, May 22nd, 6 p.m., Dudleytown Brewing Company in Windsor. And later on this month, our partner promotion, Legacy is Timeless, will proudly present Certified. That takes place later this month. Once again, Saturday, March 30th, 2 p.m. is the time to get there. It takes place at 596 Hiller Street in Manchester, Connecticut. So once again, make sure you also support Legacy is Timeless as they present Certified later on this month, March 30th. And now, our next contest is an eight-person tag team elimination match.
Let's go.
See, I'm riding high.
I got time on me.
It's the mission, baby.
I got time on me. Partner, let's go out for the sun.
I got five on me. Till the mission is complete. I got five on me. Messing with that.
Here to remind you that birds are not real. Red Sawyer. Next, hailing from the rock and roll underground, awaits none of your damn business. The devilish princess of the rock and roll underground, Dante Sumo. And finally, hailing from the 31st century, they are the true king of R&B, the musician of the mission, Dan Michael, and the face of the company, and now the creator, Dan DeMan, the mission!
There you hear the voice of the self-professed true king of R&B, Stan Michael.
And their opponents.
Oh, this top guy music right here.
Here we go. Let's get ready for war, ladies and gentlemen.
Let's get it. It's the root boy, Don Dada, top shot. Paper chaser, pound up in collars. Shorty in my phone, she want me to get a product. I don't trip, but I might toss a couple of dollars. Got a freak on the south end. She got a spooky, got another up in
Mexico. Introducing the best team first. Hailing from Westchester, Pennsylvania, weighing in at 150 pounds. Wrestling's angel, the notorious Mimi. Hailing from Maryland, Connecticut, and weighing in at 149 pounds, the 2023 Test of Strength Rookie of the Year, the TOS Youngblood. And hailing from Hartford, Connecticut, weighing in at 285 pounds, the Don Dada, the Top Shotta, the Paper Chase, and Himbo Slice, Patrick Zane.
Ladies and gentlemen at home, take a look at the back of those jumpsuits. They are the Mission Busters. I love this so much.
Cut the music.
Hang on.
Cut the music, goddamn. Yes, they do. Listen, we were supposed to have Bobby Buffet, but he messed up his knee.
He messed up?
So I want to wish Bobby Buffet a speedy recovery.
Absolutely.
Damn, you suck! Damn, you suck! Damn, you
sucks a lot. He sucks a lot. He sucks a lot. Yes, he does. But the thing about Bobby is, right? They run in threes. Hit it.
Ladies and gentlemen, their partner hailing from Hartford, Connecticut, hard-hitting Bobby Ocean!
Yeah, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. The mystery partner of Team Patrick Saint is none other than hard-hitting Bobby Ocean.
Got a tank for a car. Ice for all, got tattoos for skin and stars for bras, got a building for a bridge.
Oh, let's go. Backyards, let's go. Getting a hero's reception here at TOS. That's Test of Strength royalty right there, ladies and gentlemen. Wow, that just changed the whole complexion of this match, folks. Well, like I said, we better get ready for war here, folks. Where do we begin? The mission, which most say and acknowledge, is nothing short of a cult. Damn the man. Say what you want about him, he's got the gift of gab. He could sell ice to an Eskimo. He has convinced Red Sawyer. He has convinced Stan Michael. He's convinced Karen Bam Bam. And now, apparently, Dajay Simone to follow the teachings of the Book of Danos. The mission have run roughshod over TOS pretty much since the end of last year. At every training day, you see these guys coming out, interjecting themselves, been going to war with Patrick Saint, TOS Young Boy. Brutal attacks, disgusting sneak attacks at every turn. Once again, running roughshod, attempting to, and let's not forget, Patrick Saint, former member of the mission, now free. And we are getting a look now. These two men competed to crown the very first Test of Strength champion. Of course, that was Bobby Ocean, who lost that title to Dan the Man. This is your Test of Strength history, ladies and gentlemen. And here they are once again on the battlefield. Wow. Unbelievable aggression on display by Bobby Ocean. Everything Bobby Ocean does is aggressive. He can't go through a door without breaking the knob. He can't eat dinner without breaking the table. Hang on. Look at that Japanese arm drag. And another arm drag takes Danos down to the mat. And here we go. We get our first look at the 2023 TOS Rookie of the Year, TOS Young Boy. Inside cradle. No. Wow, look at that drop kick. TOS Young Boy has won over the TOS faithful with his grit, his determination, his hard-fought battles. Another man under the mental clutches of another mentor, this one being Jordan Rowe. He's got the name TOS Young Boy because he is the young boy of the grapple god Jordan Rowe. who treats this young man like absolute crap. TOS faithful want to see nothing more than this young man break loose of those clutches. Of course, it's Patrick Saint understands that better than anyone, breaking loose from the mission. Sound advice from him to young boy. Get out there on your own. Clip those wings, my man. Speaking of wings, we've got former NXT superstar who has also appeared on AEW television, Notorious Mimi, as we see Red getting himself involved now. A lot going on here, folks. I'm going to do my best to bring it all to you in easy-to-digest sections. Wish me luck. Oh, and look at that. Young boy was perched atop that second rope there, and Dan just come and dropped him right on the back of his head. And here comes Red Sawyer. Where do we begin with this absolute madman? Well, most people call him crazy. He's definitely a paranoid conspiracy theorist. Say what you want about him, he's an accomplished professional wrestler. He won 3 TOS awards last year. Moment of the year, promo of the year, and match of the year at the Lituation against Hippie Dickie Moon. So 3 awards for Red Sawyer. Oh, as he just puts all his weight, drops the throat of Youngboy right across the rope. Hang on. No. So for those of you new to TOS or new to Red Sawyer, the fans are chanting, birds aren't real, because surprise, surprise, this madman thinks that birds aren't real, that they are, what, flying surveillance drones or something like that? I don't know. And here now we get our first look at the self-professed true king of R&B, Stan Michael. Look at that. Doesn't get much more athletic than this guy. Lifelong athlete, amateur wrestling, karate, basketball. Double suplex now as Daje Simone goes for the cover. Oh, she's, what is this? Oh, that's right. He didn't see the tag. Nice work on the part of the referee. And there it is. Oh my God. That kick was just downright violent. And here we go, Red Sawyer back in now. So he handed me a statement to read. I told him I wasn't sure I'd have really the time for it. I guess we can try. Something about high-powered microwave. No, count of two only. High-powered microwaves. Impact victims through the, what is this? Through the Frey effect, skull axe. As receiving antenna, I'm not reading all this. Folks, you get it. This guy's out of his mind. But he feels that he is a targeted individual and that the CIA is trying to hit him with microwave weapons. As a matter of fact, he made the bold claim that the Notorious Mimi is a CIA actress, which she vehemently denied, to no one's surprise. Headbutt sends young boy hard to the mat. Oh! Red trying to get his legs up on the rope there for leverage, or the referee didn't see. Still not enough to keep young boy down. And here we see the leader of this cult known as The Mission, Dan the Man, Danos. Almost got away with it there, Stan. You ain't going to get too many more warnings. Danos, count of two only, ready for war here tonight, as is made evident by the camouflage that he dons in this battle. And at these past few training days at the end of 2023 and the beginning of 2024, well, fans, you got to get out to training day. Get over to the dojo, man. This number one dojo you've been hearing all about has TOS talent blowing up all over the place. Number one dojo, the TOS dojo. Guys got to get over there for training day, man. Hang on. No, count of one only. Patrick Saint, Youngboy, and company have been winning battles, but Again, after all these attacks, after the matches, it seems like the Mission have been winning the war. Will that be the case here tonight? Only time will tell. It's certainly looking like it's going the Mission's way now, as Red Sawyer has got his foot right between the two shoulder blades of the Young Boy, stretching those arms out, but Young Boy fighting back. No, rolls him up. No. No one will forget the performance last year by TOS Youngboy. Not one, but two matches. Oh, look at this, Enziguri. And here comes Patrick Saint, the Don Dada, the Top Shotter, the Paper Chase. Look at this, body slams for everybody. Calling in Bobby Ocean now. Using him as a weapon and drops him right on top of Dan the Man. And does the same with the Notorious Mimi. And it is all Team Saint right now. And he's calling for the 500 degrees. If he slaps that on, it's goodbye, Dan. Right into the corner. Oh, my God. And now Young Boy using Pat for leverage. Oh, my God. No, Daje in there to break up the pin. And here we go. We get our first look at pro wrestling's angel, the Notorious Mimi, on the attack now. And she's got Daje up, fireman's carry position. Oh, and I don't know if you noticed that. Daje raked the eyes on the way down. Count of two only. Look at this mean streak we see here in Daje Simone. Wow. Spin and reverse kick into the corner. Well, she better watch out for the kicks. Those educated feet of the Notorious Mimi in her Taekwondo background. Oh, look at that. Beautiful head scissors takedown. Mimi fighting back. Irish whip. Oh, my God. Popped her up for that forearm. She's got her draped across the ropes now. Makes the tag to Young Boy. Tag to Patrick Saint. Tag into Mimi. One, two, three. What do we get? Double 619s to Daje Simone. Uh-oh. She's in the wrong place. Ricky! Mimi has got Daje. One, two, three.
Daje Simone has been eliminated.
All right, so we have got our first 4-on-3 situation as Daje Simone eliminated. My God! The high-flying abilities of Stan Michael on full display right here, but hang on now. Patrick Saint with that huge chop right across the chest of the true king of R&B. Snapmare by Young Boy takes Stan Michael down. Kick to the small of the back. Once again, up on that second rope. High cross body. No. Listen to that crowd. This young man has earned their respect. Oof. No, Michael's now up and over. Oh my goodness. No. And is he setting him up for the high note? That huge splash from the top rope. We've seen him put many an opponent away with that move. He's heading to the top. Young Boy not in position for it, though. Young boy trying to make his way to the corner. Yeah, he's worse for wear right now. Yeah, smart move on the part of the young boy right there. Oh my God! Michael went, hold on. Goodbye.
Stan Michael has been eliminated.
Stan Michael went for the high note and instead he got caught in mid-air with the Ricky. Unbelievable, ladies and gentlemen. Jesus Christ. Wow. Never mind, welcome to the House of Soul. Welcome to the House of Ricky. Oh, and look at that. Pat didn't see it. Red creeping up from behind. Oh, and there we see on the outside the artist formerly known as Dashing D in the corner of Team Pat. Dan the Man now on the attack. The mastermind behind the mission. The author of the Book of Danos. The teachings that the mission follow. Oh my God. Here we go, young boy. Oh my goodness. Listen to that crowd. Young boy has said because of his size, he has always had to fight twice as hard, has always had to work twice as hard as everybody else. And we're seeing the results of that on full display. Uh-oh, young boy's going up. Yes, he is, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, he is. Reluctantly making his way to the top rope. Not sure. I don't know if Dan not in the position that he wants him to be in, but he's quite reluctant to make it to the top rope. Oh, here we go. Rallying the fans now. Maybe setting him up for a high crossbody. Oh, what's this? Oh, it's Jordan Rowe, his mentor. Don't listen to him, young boy. Come on. Oh, we have seen this time and time again. Leave him alone, Rowe. Oh. You know, you hate to see this. We know it's your mentor at all. We know that you're a respectful young man, but... Young boy was right on the cusp of getting, presumably, another elimination here. And out comes Jordan Rowe, his mentor, with some advice.
Screw you.
Wow! Yes! Finally! Good for you, young boy. He just told Jordan Rowe what's what it looks like. He just quit. Oh no! Come on! Rowe throws him off the top rope right into the snap. No, 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 not like this. Damn it!
The TOS young boy has been eliminated.
All right, well. TOS young boy eliminated after the interference by his former mentor. Mimi now in the corner. He's got Dan the Man's shirt draped right over his face as he's the recipient of those vicious chops. Going for a suplex now. Not enough. Oh, look at this. Beautiful, beautiful maneuver there by Mimi, but not enough to keep Danos down for the pin. And this crowd is on fire, ladies and gentlemen. They want to see, want nothing more than to see Team Patrick Sane, hang on, defeat the mission here tonight. Red there to break up the pin. I still can't believe what I saw. I had no time to celebrate the fact that Jordan, TOS Youngboy quit the mentorship of Jordan Rowe, who couldn't handle the embarrassment, and he went ahead and threw Youngboy off the ropes inadvertently right into that snap. Youngboy eliminated, but wow. Uh-oh. Look at that. Not sure if the referee from his vantage point was able to see that. Looks like he did. Nonetheless, Danos now getting himself some separation off that rake of the eyes on the notorious Mimi. Oh, suplex. He got all of that one. There we go. Big boot by the notorious Mimi. And another one. Up. Mimi up and over. Rolls him up. No, not enough. And just kicks him right in the mouth. What do we got? He's got him up. Look at the strength of Notorious Mimi. Oh no, and there's Red once again. Double clothesline by Wrestling's Angel. Big boot in the corner. Mimi up on the top rope, high cross body. Heaven sent kick. She hit him with the heaven sent kick. Oh no. That's gonna be it for the notorious Mimi. Oh, look at this, what? No, he says. Oh no. Amy's out. Look at that. Dan the Man sending a message.
The notorious Mimi has been eliminated.
And we are down to 2-on-2, ladies and gentlemen. Patrick Saint and Bobby Ocean. Across the ring from Dan the Man and Red Sawyer. Long-time rivals, two veterans. Look at him. Oh, yeah, okay. Wow. Ugh. Ladies and gentlemen, that is as painful as it looks and as painful as it sounds. Oh, my God. Red tagged in. Can't, it's unbelievable. The pure aggression, the high impact offense, everything Bobby Ocean does. Jesus. Oh, reversal by Red. Eats a boot for his efforts. Huge DDT right in the middle of the ring. And is he setting him up for Snapmare? Textbook. That's classic Bobby. Hold on. Oh, wait. No, no, no. Almost. That was almost. That was close. That was close. That was. That's about as close as it gets, ladies and gentlemen. Bobby Ocean now. Rallying the TOS faithful. Thank you. Great call on the part of the referee. It was as close as it gets on that count right there. Oh, and the neck breaker by Red. No. Red now, what's he setting Bobby Ocean up for? He's got him in the corner. Gut wrench. Listen to this man grunting, screaming, growling. His penchant for violence, unmatched. Red, presumably under the spell of Dan the Man here. The control that Dan has over this man, withholding his meds. Getting in the mind of Red, false promises. Dan, Red feels like he's trapped in the mission. He feels that Patrick Sane, after he left, that he betrayed Red. Turned his back already, was his only friend. And you heard him just yell to Dan, what do you want from me? Whatever it is that he wants, we know at the end of the day, it's only going to be good for Dan the Man as Red Sawyer powerbomb. And Dan the Man in there to break the pin up. And here comes Pat. Saint throws Danos outside the ring. And they're brawling on the outside now. Fans hightailing it. Look at this now. Dan is burying Patrick Sane in chairs on the outside. Look at this. Red's got that Asiatic spike. No. Is he able to get it? It looks like Bobby Ocean's got it blocked. Ocean's got it blocked. Gets him over. One hit a quitter. Good night, Red. Thanks for coming, Red. And Dan the Man.
Red Sawyer has been eliminated.
Dan the Man is on his own. He's got no more cult members to rely on. And this is going to be an uphill battle for Dan the Man. But let's not forget, this man is always one step ahead of his opponents. The devious, dastardly mentality of Dan the Man. Who knows what he has in store at this point, ladies and gentlemen. But right about now, we have got Dan the Man, Bobby Ocean, about to square off right in the middle of the ring. Patrick Sane is hurt on the outside. He got hit hard. Wait a minute. Red's back in and he's got that chain. He just hit Bobby Ocean with that chain. Referee didn't see it. Like I said, never count this man out. Snap! And he got all of it. Ocean eliminated.
Bobby Ocean has been eliminated.
Not without the help of an already eliminated Red Sawyer with that chain, and we are down to Patrick Saint and Dan the Man. And this is what this whole war is all about. Patrick Saint. A free man, no longer under the clutches, the mental clutches. Oh, hold on. Oh, he just got that stomp right in the middle of the ring. Taunting Patrick Saint, yelling out Ricky right before the snap, but hang on, Saint back up to his feet. Saint just got right back up to his feet. He just brushed that snap right off. And Dan the Man cannot believe what he's seeing, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, boy. Bomba Clad Lariat. And he got all of it.
I hate you.
Dan up and over. Once again, clothesline in the corner. Wow. Another overhead throw there by Patrick Saint. He just asked the crowd who wants to see a dead body. Oh, my God. Oh, no. Dan the Man. He's got the milk. He's got the cupcakes. He's got the scratch ticket. He just told Trey they should split up. And this right here, ladies and gentlemen, looks like the beginning of the end for Dan the Man. Chomping at the bit is Patrick Saint. He went for the Ricky, but he missed. Hard into the post. Hold on. Red back with the chain. Saint missed with the Ricky, went hard into the post. Low blow. Referee distracted by Red Sawyer. And Dan the Man with the low blow. Snap. And that's it.
Ladies and gentlemen, Patrick Saint has been eliminated. Therefore, your winners, the team of Dajae Simone, Red Sawyer, Stan Michael, and Dan DeMan.
Unbelievable, ladies and gentlemen. Victory at all cost, and ladies and gentlemen, believe me, he pulled out all the stops for this one. As we see his mission members, his cult members helping him to his feet. Mission victorious here today at Lone Survivor 5. Is there nothing anybody can do to stop the mission? If there is, we haven't seen it yet. Dan the Man in the mission, stronger than ever. Got to be a heartbreaker for young Patrick Saint to take absolutely nothing away from this man. What a match. What a battle that was. Wow. What a match, ladies and gentlemen. Well-deserved ovation for the Don Dada, the top shotter. Breath after that one.
All right, everyone, real quick, just a reminder, make sure you are following Test of Strength on all social media accounts. Test of Strength on Facebook, at TOS Wrestling 1 on Twitter/X and Instagram. Match announcements, event announcements, ticket information, all news related to Test of Strength. Those are your go-to sources. And do not forget to like, subscribe, and share to the YouTube channel. That is also TOS Wrestling 1. Make sure you show all of your friends what they are missing here and relive all of the great moments from Test of Strength past. on the YouTube channel, TOS Wrestling 1. And don't forget to follow Legacy is Timeless as well. That is at LIT Pro Wrestling on all social media accounts, Facebook, Twitter/X, Instagram, YouTube as well. So make sure you're liking, subscribing, and sharing. And don't forget about Certified coming up later this month, March 30th, presented by Legacy is Timeless. And now, the following contest is the Lone Survivor Elimination Match, where the winner will become number one contender for a championship of their choosing at Fight for Your Dream 7.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. Yeah. The Lone Survivor match about to begin. I can't wait.
Next kings, leave me alone when I'm a fighter.
Introducing first, now making his way to the ring, hailing from Atlantic City, New Jersey, weighing in at 295 pounds, this is the inevitable icon, Travis Jericho.
Of all time. He's held every title down there. This is a dangerous, dangerous individual here, ladies and gentlemen.
The next competitor.
Mister, I might start a riot. Opposite of quiet. Yeah, on the tires. How about you try it? Try it.
Now making his way to the ring, hailing from the 845 New York, weighing at 200 pounds, he is the Pretty Boy Shooter, AJ Joseph Alexander. The next competitor.
Yeah. Ride with the mob, alhamdulillah. Check in with me and do your job. Berg is the name, Bimbola did the chain. Tono for the watch, Prezi plain Jane. Yeah, Bikini Jane, rest in peace to my superior. Hermes Linga from the village in Liberia. TMZ taking pictures cause they're my hysteria. Mama CDR, he is not
tearing up.
It's time to get that truck. I get to get Harlem picnics when you reach your high.
Dead or alive, the next competitor. Approaching the ring, hailing from Buffalo, New York, weighing in at 220 pounds, this is the Ross Show, Keith Youngblood.
Now I am very, very excited about this. This will be my first time calling a match of Keith Youngblood's almost 10 years in the game. The Lost Soul has as good a chance as anybody at walking out of here with the number one contendership.
The next competitor.
This place is about to
erupt, ladies
and gentlemen.
You may not see it every time you look up at the sky, but the moon is always there.
Step right up, moon killer, now pillar! Shady and steady, I'm blowing in the blood, I'll rise to the top till the real
don't get up. His way to the ring of Syracuse, New York, weighing in at 203 pounds, he is the Moonlight Sun! The final competitor.
Listen to that crowd. Look at Frost, ever the sportsman. But he is as ready tonight as ever. Six man. Elimination style. There's the bell, and here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Starting this one off, Mike Skyros, Keith Youngblood. This on its own be a main event in any arena. Here we go, the veteran maneuvers of Keith Youngblood. Look at this, a little back and forth here by Skyros and Youngblood to set this one off. Youngblood escapes the headlock. Shoulder tackle sends the Moonlight Sun hard to the mat. Leapfrog and right back into the headlock. How do you gain an advantage in this match? When you've got five other competitors doing everything they can to stop you. Certain situations will be created that these guys are going to have to take advantage of one way or the other. Temporary alliances, mistakes, miscalculations. Youngblood off the ropes. Going for that arm drag, no dice. Youngblood sends Skyros hard to the mat. Big man getting up there for that drop kick. And here we'll get our first look at A-game. Tags himself in. The pretty boy shooter. Over 16 years plus experience in Greco-Roman and freestyle wrestling. And we get our first look at Big Travis Jacobs all the way from the Monster Factory. How would that be? For test of strength for this guy to walk right in here and win Lone Survivor 5, number one contendership. Actually, Sammy Diaz had some very choice words about that. In particular, well, these guys, you think you're gonna walk into my house, win my match, take my number one contendership? I don't think so. But from the looks of that shoulder tackle, I think Travis Jacobs has other ideas. Oh my God. Ugh. Listen to these sick, sadistic fans one more time. Oh, man. Jeez. And here we go. Top five, dead or alive. Pure pro wrestling. Perfection. Everything this man does, crisp, clean, almost effortless. This man was born to do this. You hear stories about his first day at training at TOS. He was already doing everything perfectly. This guy, shooting star pressed out of the womb, right into life. And here's the undeniable Ryan Fraust. Of course, TOS faithful know that by all accounts, Ryan Fraust should be TOS champion. Hashtag Waterbury Screwjob, hashtag never forget. But I digress. Nope. Sammy, we'll try that again. Diaz hard into the corner. Look at those clubbing shots to the midsection. Oh, Christ's sake. I've said it before and I'll say it again. Man, am I glad that isn't me. I like my spot right here at the table. Oh, my God. Almost beeled him into the next town. Manhandling Sammy Diaz. Now, why? I'm very curious as to why. I mean, there has to be some kind of game plan. Why would A-game stop one of these competitors from being eliminated? Unless, of course, there's some kind of plan between these two to work together. But again, even if that was the case, when the two of them are left alone, one of them's got to win. And there's a meeting of the minds right there. Diaz, hard to the mat. Frost Force, leading the chance of Frosty as you hear them reverberate across Warehouse 635 here tonight. Oh, Skyros tagging himself in. Much to the dismay of Ryan Frost, and look at that. Diaz using Frost as a weapon, pushing him right into, oh, hold on. Wow! Unbelievable! Sammy Diaz with that tope suicida and sends Mike Skyros right into the Frost Force. Unbelievable, ladies and gentlemen. Again, you talk about Sammy Diaz and his stock rise in this past year. One of the most sought-after talents in all the Northeast, which is, of course, the hottest area in independent wrestling. So we're seeing it now, this seemingly temporary alliance between Sammy Diaz and Joseph Alexander. Alexander. But Skyros ducks the line, ducks the back fist. Oh, man. Once, twice, but not thrice. Hang on. No, count of one only. What are you arguing about? It was only a count of one. Perhaps these two are working together solely to eliminate what they see as one of the biggest threats in the match, the Moonlight Sun. And maybe once they get him eliminated, the alliance will be over. Who knows? Time will tell. And now, Diaz. Wearing down the Moonlight Sun. Trying to block the flow of blood to the brain. No, he's out. Moonlight Sun up and over. And there's a tag once again to the inevitable icon. This giant grizzly bear of a human being. Oh boy. Adios, gee whiz. And there's one for A-game. Unbelievable. Enough to share for everybody. And it looks like he's gonna go coast to coast with those clotheslines in the corner. Back elbow. Got him up, fireman's carry position. Drops him right on the knee. Jacobs is on fire right now, ladies and gentlemen. Once again, drops Diaz down on his knee. Oh, wow. And once again, another breakup of a pin, which I'm surprised to see. Now we got these two big men about to square off. Ryan Fraust, Travis Jacobs. Let's see, what do we got? Oof. Oh my God! I hope the cameraman gets the faces of these fans. All around Warehouse 635, everybody grimacing. Oh, my God. Jacobs took it like a champ, though. Oh, my God. Fighting spirit on full display, folks. Who can take the pain? Who can endure the punishment more? What it's also doing is giving these other four competitors time to regroup. Time to catch a breather on the outside. Forearm. Right hand. Back and forth. Frosty now getting the better of this exchange. Irish whip. Ooh, Jacobs ducks the line and hits him with one of his own. A game back in now. Look at those brutal knee strikes. Those kicks right to the head of Travis Jacobs. He keeps this up, he's gonna knock him out. My God. No, Jacob ducks the kick. Oh, my goodness, look at that maneuver. And once again, Diaz in. Hold on. Jacob's been eliminated. See, I may have
Travis
spoken too
Jacobs
soon,
Jacobs has
folks.
Been eliminated.
Because that game plan that they seem presumably had together works because Jacobs is now eliminated. Look at that Blue Thunder Bomb. Oh. Oh, man. Close as you get right there, folks. Youngblood now rallying the TOS faithful. Once again, A game in. That shot across the throat to Youngblood took a lot out of him. Oh, look at that. Beautiful, beautiful bridging German right there. A game on the attack. Dropping those knees to the back of the head of Keith Youngblood. Now taunting the lost soul. Youngblood's had enough. These guys are gonna chop each other to death, man. I swear to God. Youngblood into the ropes. Oh, he paused. Oh! Super kick. Saito suplex dropped him right on his head. Not enough. And you can really see the frustration start to set in there for A-Game. He's had a lot of opportunities for a lot of pinfalls. Look at that. He's just look. I can't tell where he's got that grip right across the, seemingly across the throat of the lost soul, Keith Youngblood. Youngblood fighting out of it now. And Zagiri gets all of it. Clothesline. Another one. And a double avalanche in the corner. Another one. Youngblood out of the way. Look at that. Athleticism on full display. Wow. Up and over Diaz. Shot to A-Game. Kick to Diaz. Twisting suplex right in the middle of the ring. Is that it? No, not enough to eliminate the A-Game. Wow, what action, ladies and gentlemen. Classic Keith Youngblood offense right there. Looks like now's the perfect time to go for the cover. Youngblood setting him up for one more move. No. Vicious right hand by Alexander. Wow, Youngblood firing up. But he eats a kick for his efforts there. Look at this, wow. Youngblood came to win. Oof. Oh, look at that, A-Game with the trip. One, two, still not enough. At this point, Alexander's gotta wonder what does he have to do to put Keith Youngblood down. Yes, it is, ladies and gentlemen. Indeed, it is. No. gets out of that rock bottom. Oh, and drops him with that. Hold on. Reverse DDT, and he got him.
Joseph Alexander has been eliminated.
Hell of an effort here tonight by A-game Joseph Alexander. Oh, and look at this. Youngblood going. No, Diaz out of it. Oh, and a low blow. Ref Bill didn't see it. Diaz with the low blow. And just like that,
Keith Youngblood has been eliminated.
Oh boy. Sammy Diaz might be wishing he was somewhere else right now. Double chops sends the ace hard to the mat. And now we've got one-on-one in the middle of the ring. Mike Skyros, Ryan Fraust, two of the most beloved competitors in TOS history. This match has just been brutal from the outset. Unbelievable, ladies and gentlemen. Enzigiri. Now here's Skyros. Going for a suplex. No. Frost fights his way out of it. Skyros into the corner. Clothesline trying to chop down the big tree here. Another one. Frosty still on his feet. Huge, huge side slam. No doubt Frosty looking to set Skyros up for the Brass City Slam. Look at that strength of Mike Skyros. The armbands are off, ladies and gentlemen, and it looks like he might be trying to dial up Skyfall. That second rope DDT that he has put away so many competitors with. If he hits it, Frosty's gone. Wait a minute. Sammy Diaz stopping the Skyfall, and here we go. He's got him up. Brass City Slam. And Mike Skyros has been eliminated.
Mike Skyros has been eliminated.
And just like that, Sammy Diaz on the attack. And we are down to the final two, ladies and gentlemen. Big shoulder tackle there by the undeniable Ryan Fraust. Two TOS originals battling in the middle of the ring for that coveted number one contendership. Fall away slam. And ladies and gentlemen, he got all of it. Oh, and he's got him up now. Going for the Brass City Slam, but look at that. Sammy Diaz grabbing Ref Bill. And he's got the foot up for a low blow. Ref Bill didn't see it. Low blow. Set him up for the cradle shot. He got it. Oh, no. And that's it.
Ladies and gentlemen, Ryan Fraust has been eliminated. Therefore, your winner, the ace, top five, dead or alive, Sammy Diaz.
the name. Then Baller did the chain.
What a heartbreaker for Ryan Fraust, man.
Cause he playing Jane.
All right, everybody, I am here with your winner, the ace, top five, dead or alive, Sammy Diaz. And as I mentioned at the top of the match, the winner of that Lone Survivor match would go on to fight for your dreams for a number one contendership opportunity at any championship of their choosing. Ace, what are you thinking?
There's only one. There's only one championship I haven't won in this company. And everybody knows my goal is to become the first ever Triple Crown. And that's what's gonna be. The winner of that will be top five, dead or alive.
Well, you heard him, ladies and gentlemen, in his quest to become the very first TOS Triple Crown winner, Sammy Diaz, victorious here tonight in the Lone Survivor match.
I attended Harlem picnics where you risk your life. Uncle used to skim work selling Knicks at night. I was only 8 years old watching Nick at night. Uncle Psycho was in that bathroom bucket. Knife to his gut, hope daddy don't cut him. Suicidal thoughts brought to me with no advisory. He was pitching dummies, selling fiends, mad ivory. Grandma had the arthritis in her hands.
All right, everybody, before we get to the next order of business, just a couple of quick reminders. Don't forget to check out the HS Apparel booth. Beanies and t-shirts for $10, hoodies for $30. Those are some very good deals, so make sure you take advantage of them and check out the HS Apparel merchandise booth. And don't be shy and step up and say hello to some of your favorite Test of Strength wrestlers at their merchandise booths all around the arena. You can get a t-shirt, an 8x10, an autograph, or a photo, whatever it is you want. They'll make sure you go home happy with a tremendous memento from what is a tremendous night here at Test of Strength. So once again, check out the HS Apparel booth and check out the booths of your favorite Test of Strength wrestlers. And now, our next contest is a tag team match scheduled for one fall. And it is for the Test of Strength Tag Team Championship!
Ladies and gentlemen, batten down the hatches. Get your seatbelts on. This one is going to be an absolute banger.
I got this feeling on the summer day when
this
you were gone. I crashed my car into the bridge.
One
I watched
the
let it burn. I threw
we've
your shit
in
into a bag and pushed
these
it downstairs. I crashed my car into the bridge. I don't care.
Straight to the chase. I'm not one to point out the obvious, but the obvious thing is my partner Kylon King is not here tonight.
What?
Unfortunately, Kylan was not cleared by doctors to compete tonight for the TOS Tag Team Championships. But that didn't stop me because I know how hard these two have worked here at Test of Strength over the past few months. I know how hard these two have worked to get a shot at these tag team titles, and I'm not gonna forget that. So I showed up here today to fight because I know you guys want this match. We've been looking forward to it too, but Kylan can't be here, but that doesn't mean that I don't have other brothers in the back. So, I think you're the only one, pal. But as I was trying to say, I have other brothers in the back. So tonight, taking Kylan King's spot in this Test of Strength Wrestling Tag Team Championship match will be none other than one half of the Haven, Sean Knight.
Kush roll, glass full, I prefer the better things. With no money, act like money isn't everything. I'm having a good time, they just trying to ruin it. Shout out to the fact that I'm the youngest doing it. Cap on, grimping, dancing, later time. She ain't trying to pop that for pimp, okay, well, never mind.
Okay, I tried to told you, Drizzy,
still ain't nothing nice. Brace the saying you should quit. Car saying f*** your life. Okay, now we out of here. Toodles to
and
you.
And if you dialed up, I got the voodoo for you.
Yeah, I'm busy getting rich. I don't want trouble. I made enough for two. Boy, stunt double. Famous like a drug that I've taken too much of. But I never ever trip. Just peace,
here
happiness, and love.
And
I got
Prince
money
of
in
greatness,
these jeans,
Sean Knight,
so they fit me
replacing
slow,
the Kylan King.
Let's get the official introductions first.
Introducing first, the challengers. Hailing from Long Island, New York, and Stratford, Connecticut, respectively. Weighing in at a combined weight of 361 pounds, they are the technician, Mark Alexander, and hyper-violent Nolan Pierce, Counter-Strike! And their opponents, hailing from the 203 and weighing in at a combined weight of 385 pounds, they are the reigning, defending, Test of Strength Tag Team Champions, the Prince of Greatness, Sean Knight, the Speed Sensation, Dustin Flash Waller, Miracle Generation!
All right, wow. Unbelievable turn of events here, folks. So it looks like I'm going to have to take back everything I said at the outset of this thing here. Because this might be the opportunity. This might be exactly what Counter-Strike needs, that little edge, that little push that they might need tonight to gain some kind of advantage. And conversely, that might not be the case at all, because let's not forget, fans of Test of Strength, fans of Connecticut Wrestling, fans of Miracle Generation know Sean Knight is not some random guy that they just grabbed and threw in there. Sean Knight is not just, you know, a friend who's willing to step in. By all accounts, Sean Knight is a member of Miracle Generation. Let's not forget, Dustin Flash Waller, Kylan King, Jay Onyx, Sean Knight, all came up together, all trained together at PAPW, and collectively the four of them are known as Miracle Generation. So as much as this may seem like, presumably, like a gift to Counter-Strike, I definitely wouldn't go that far. It's still Miracle Generation. Wow, what an exchange in the middle of the ring there by these two young athletes. And you know, what a class act Dustin Flash Waller is. He knew he could have backed out of this match. He could have waited. He could have made Counter-Strike wait. Ooh, whoa, 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 whoa. That roll-up was so quick, I didn't even see it. And I think that's the kind of action that we're going to see in this match, ladies and gentlemen. Fast pace. And now we see, hold on, can't really hear what they're saying, but it looks like Flash is telling Sean Knight, slow it down, calm it down. Keep your head in the game.
Now we see the beautiful tag team maneuvers of Counter-Strike. The technician, Mark Alexander, handles the counters. The hyper-violent Nolan Pierce handles the strikes. Like I told you, these two best friends, roommates, fight together, train together. They know each other like the back of their hand. Oh, wow, hold on a second. Look at that. Wow, we didn't expect to see that one. Miracle Generation, Dustin Flashwall just threw us for a loop with that cheap shot on the outside. And here comes Flash. Uh-oh. Sean Knight now looking to fly. And he's off. Look at that Counter-Strike right out of the way. Trying to lock down their target, having a hard time doing so. Once again, Counter-Strike. Ducking the aerial attack, but not for long because Big Match Dusty up and over. What are we gonna get here? Springboard moonsault to the outside? Oh, look at that. Oh my goodness. Sean Knight with the dive to the outside. Meanwhile, Big Match Dusty landing with all of his weight right on the small of the back of Nolan Pierce. And there's the tag. Big Match Dusty once again. On the second rope. Double axe handle to the small of the back. And you can see already that red welt on the lower back of Nolan Pierce. Have Miracle Generation zeroed in on it. Great to see Blue Shoes back in the TOS ring here. Another TOS legend. One of the absolute best referees in the game. Waller's got that knee right between the shoulder blades. Stretching out the arms of the hyper-violent Nolan Pierce, who makes his way to his feet. Oh, Flash hangs on. You know, at the Lone Survivor 5 press conference, it was Mark Alexander said they were going to attempt to slow down Miracle Generation. It looks like the opposite. It looks like Miracle Generation are attempting to slow down the high-octane offense of Counter-Strike. And to great effect. But Nolan Pierce finding a way out, going for the tag. No Knight in there to stop the momentum, stop the movement. Oh, and look at that. Nolan Pierce going for the tag, and Big Match Dusty just pulls Mark Alexander right off of the ring apron. Enziguri. Wow. Running knee strike. Count of two only. Talking earlier about training day. Of course, at training day 42, Dustin Waller defeated Mark Alexander in singles competition, and then at training day 43, he defeated Nolan Pierce. So that's got to be a thorn in the side of Counter-Strike. Conversely, hang on now. Conversely, Counter-Strike had two big victories at the following two training days.
One over Hustle and Muscle, the other over Sammy Diaz and the champion, the Underground King. So they've definitely got some momentum coming into this match. Speaking of momentum, Mark Alexander is an absolute house on fire right now. Ducks the double clothesline and one of his own. Listen to that crowd. Manhattan drop. Hold that for a second. Alexander off the ropes. Two for one. Not enough. Creative offense on full display there by the technician, Mark Alexander. Dialing it up here, folks. Went for that shining wizard. Sean Knight out of the way. Falcon arrow. No. Big Match Dusty thinks that count was slow. Waller's got him up. What do we got here? No, there's Nolan Pierce with the super kick to break up that double team attempt. Double knees into the German. Beautiful tag team offense here by Counter-Strike. Alexander's got him up. Huge knee. And Knight in to break up the pin. What action, ladies and gentlemen. These guys laying it all on the line. Scoop slam. Running knee, and he got all of it. Sean Knight wisely rolling to the outside. Oh, my God. And there's the Shining Wizard. He got it. Mark Alexander with that patented Shining Wizard of his. Oh, but doesn't have the energy to get over and make the pin. Man, these guys giving it all they got. It's all on the line here, folks. TOS Tag Team titles. Like I said, it's going to come down to who wants it more. Look at this, both men pulling their partners to the side, getting that legal tag. We got Sean Knight, we got Mark Alexander right in the middle of the ring, trading shots. Knight, Alexander, right hand. Alexander with one of his own. Fighting spirit on full display here. TOS, Lone Survivor 5. Mark Alexander now dropping those forearms, and here comes Big Match Dusty. Breaks it up. And here comes the hyperviolent Nolan Pierce. This thing's breaking down into a full-on Donnybrook, ladies and gentlemen. Fists are flying. Ref Jean has got her hands full. Look at that. Miracle Generation going for the tandem tag team offense, and it was Counter-Strike one step ahead of them. And just like that, Miracle Generation with a reversal of their own. This time one step ahead, stereo super kicks. Miracle Generation on the attack. Oh, look at that. Classic Dustin Waller offense right there. Oh, 2 3/4. The handspring stunner, not enough to keep Mark Alexander down. Frustration's got to be starting to set in for Miracle Generation. Here we go. It looks like Miracle Generation are ready to close the book on this one. Oh, brutal super kick. Waller now reaching into a dark place. Gotta wonder if that frustration now and their inability at this point in the match to put away Counter-Strike is starting to set in. Oh no. Double super kick. Oh my God. And Mark Alexander back up to his feet. Dustin asked, do you want to see him fight? Well, here we go. We're seeing him fight, all right. Getting a second win here is the technician. Oh, tripped up. Oh! They missed the double kicks. Shins collide. Missed again. Knight went for that super kick. Alexander out of the way, and it was Dustin Flash Waller that ate it. And there's a kick by Nolan Pierce. Tope Suicida from Alexander to the outside. Super kick. Knight doesn't know where he is. Oh, man. Counter-Strike have got Sean Knight right where they want him. High and low. This could be it. We got new champions.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are your winners and the new Test of Strength Tag Team Champions, the technician, Mark Alexander, Hyper Violent, Nolan Pierce, Counter Strike.
Standing ovation for this young team. What a match, ladies and gentlemen. Hang on. Miracle Generation back in the ring now. Dustin Waller's got the mic. Oh, he just snatched the, they snatched the belts back. Hold on.
All right. While I somewhat agree with that chant, because I've heard it before, myself and my brother Kyle Lyon, we like to go by something different. We don't deserve anything. They don't deserve anything. They earned it.
Amen.
You guys earned it. You were the better team. You got some big shoes to fill, but I know damn true you guys are going to fill them.
A class act, ladies and gentlemen. Absolute class act. Love to see this. Gotta give it up for these guys, man. Your new Test of Strength Tag Team Champions, Nolan Pierce, Mark Alexander, Counter-Strike. So it's hard for me to stay professional sometimes because right now I am just so happy for these two young men. Earned it indeed. Wow.
right. Make the rounds, guys.
It is a whole new day here in the Test of Strength Tag Team Division. New Kings of the Mountain.
Yeah.
Somebody must have kicked the cord out of the music there, but anyway, congratulations, Counter-Strike.
All right, everybody, real quick, once again, big thank you to our friends and supporters here tonight, Pure Vanguard Wrestling. Also, big shout out to Headlocks for Humanity. And don't forget about the after party coming your way at Americana right down the road. And once again, next month, Test of Strength will be back for Training Day 47, Sunday, April 14th. The following month in May, Dear Normal 4 is Wednesday, May 22nd at Dudley Town Brewing Company in Windsor. And later on this month, March 30th, Saturday in the afternoon, Legacy is Timeless will present Certified. We got a lot of good stuff coming your way. So once again, make sure you're staying tuned to the Legacy is Timeless and Test of Strength social medias at Lit Pro Wrestling and at TOS Wrestling 1 on all platforms. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it is that time of the night where I ask all of you, are you ready? Your main event of the evening is a champion versus champion match, winner take all, for the Test of Strength K1 Classic Championship and the Test of Strength Championship. And now, your special guest referee for this match.
And the magnificent.
No. No.
Come on, you gotta be kidding me. What the hell?
And this is our special guest referee, the magnificent Marcos. Undoubtedly, Underground King, pulling strings here in TOS to make that happen. Yeah, he's going to call it right down the middle. We're sure. Ladies and gentlemen, this place is about to explode. Undoubtedly, the number one wrestler in all.
Introducing the first champion. He is accompanied by the Council of the Underground, Big Meazy. Hailing from Boston, Massachusetts, by way of Kingston, Jamaica. Weighing in at 240 pounds, he is the reigning and defending Test of Strength champion, the Underground King. Introducing the next champion, his opponent. He hails from the number one dojo and weighed in at 71 kilos. He is the reigning, defending, Test of Strength K1 Classic champion. He is number one, Ichiban.
Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. The time for talk is over.
And your special guest referee, once the action begins, the magnificent Marco.
Sorry, excuse me. Ugh. Took the words right out of my mouth. Well, this is it, ladies and gentlemen. Past, present, and future collide. It's teacher versus student. Legacy versus destiny. Champion versus champion. Damn it, this is Luke versus Vader right now, ladies and gentlemen. There's the bell and that feeling in the air. It's that feeling that made us all fall in love with this thing called pro wrestling. It's that feeling that compelled so many young men and women to make their way to 87 Church Street, to the dojo, TOS Dojo, number one dojo. And here we are, ladies and gentlemen, on the cusp of history. Oh my God, Underground King just caught Ichiban. No, Ichiban out. Crucifix, throws him up. No. Look at that, beautifully done. Ichiban coming out of house on fire, right out of the gate here. Ichi looking to fly. Oh my God, no, he got caught. Unbelievable. Oh no, what do we got? Big right hand by Ichiban. Little too close out there to Big Meazy for my liking. It could say referee's right there, but it's Marco, so means absolutely nothing. Special guest referee, magnificent Marcos, former TOS heavyweight champion himself. One of the most hated. Hold on, let's count. One, one, look at that. Underground King with an attempt to grab that chair, and hold on a second. Ichiban now has got it set up. Once again caught in midair and dropped. Oh my God. Oh no. That's bad, ladies and gentlemen. He didn't get dropped horizontally, man. He got dropped vertically. Right across that ring apron. Oh no. And Underground King now. Oh. Slamming Ichiban into those solid steel steps. Just like that, the momentum has switched. Come on. Get back to the ring. Underground King taunting Ichiban on the outside. Ichiban fighting his way out. Gets that water into the face of the Underground King. Looks like it might have blinded him a little bit. Rolls the champion, the TOS champion, I should say, back into the ring. Oh, I cringe every time I look at the ring and see Magnificent Marcos with a referee shirt on. Is he going to do what I think he's going to do? Look at that, Ichiban. With the escape. Big right hand. Another one. Just unloading on the Underground King in the corner. Oh my God, Underground King with the reversal. And he just clobbered Ichiban. Oof. Yeah, one. We all saw it. Underground King now off the ropes, drops the knee. Once again, only a count of one. I'll tell you that, Ichiban getting dropped across that ring apron and then slammed right into the solid steel steps has taken a lot out of him. Oh, as he just got that knee right across the throat of our K1 Classic champion, Ichiban. Oh, hang on. Almost 2.5 years reign as the K1 Classic champion here. And if Underground King keeps this up, this could be Ichiban's final day as K1 Classic champion. We've said it before and we'll say it again. We've seen Ichiban and seemingly insurmountable odds fight his way back. And he is attempting to do that right now. Underground King's got the submission locked in. Ichiban fighting his way out. Left hand's trying to get some separation. Ichiban off the ropes. Ducks the back fist. Ducks the clothesline. Once again to the outside. No, Ichiban hangs on. Gets him with the kick. Hang on. Jimmy Mees now. Attempting to hoist Ichiban up. Come on, bro. Oh, and look at that Falcon Arrow back into the ring. No, count of two only. It isn't a possibility, it is a certainty that Jimmy Mees will somehow interject himself in this match at any cost. They've already admitted, they said the bad part out loud at the Lone Survivor 5 press conference. They're gonna do anything to win. They admitted it, they said it. And now somehow we see that the choice for guest referee in this, the biggest match in TOS history, is Magnificent Marcos. And we're trying to say that these guys had nothing to do with it. I mean, I'm not one to say. I have no idea. I'm not privy to this information. I guess we'll have to sit back, wait, and see. Time will tell.
I'm going to bring this back.
No, you're not.
We're not.
No, you're not.
No, you won't. This is your number one.
Underground King, the veteran, the legend, the New England Pro Wrestling Hall of Famer now. taunting Ichiban. Oh, my God. Oh, no. And like we said, after that drop on the apron on the outside, he's now working that back. He's got him up draped over his shoulder. Ichiban could tap, ladies and gentlemen. Look at his leg twitching in agony. Can he hang on? Or will he tap? Will we see a new double champion here in TOS? Or will we see Ichiban, like he always does, fight his way out? He escapes. Ichiban sends Underground King into the corner, rolls him up. Look at that stunner, beautifully done. Handspring elbow into the corner, classic Ichiban offense. On the second rope, beautiful drop kick. Ichiban getting a second win. Beautiful. Unbelievable athleticism on full display. Ichiban with that Topekon heel right over the top rope to the outside. Looked like he was lining him up for Ichiban Kai. Didn't get it. Look at this. No. Enzigiri. Another foot and UGK down. Oh, man. Yeah, that was close. That was close, all right. Wow. Fans on the edge of their seat here. I think they all thought that was going to be it. Crowd now rallying behind their K1 Classic champion. Oh, no. Once again, one step ahead, Underground King caught Ichiban in midair and slammed him right down on that already hurt back. The veteran tactics, seeing the weakness, taking full advantage of it. And he has got Ichiban now on the top rope, setting him up. What do we got here? Superplex. He hits this, it could be the beginning of the end for Ichiban. No, Ichiban fights his way out on the second rope now. Oh, and look at that. Underground King caught him again. Underground King seemingly has an answer for almost everything that Ichiban has dished out thus far. If you got folks at home could hear that, but Underground King just said he's finished. He is ready to put the nail in the coffin in this one and secure his fate, the patriarch here of TOS, the king. Heavy lies the crown. And will this be the final coronation here tonight for the man formerly known as Slick Wagner Brown, the legend? Is this the beginning of the end for Ichiban? He's getting him up now. Oh my God, look at this, Ichiban out of it. Jumping knee strike. Off the ropes. Canadian Destroyer. Whoa, 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 what? What happened? What? What the hell was that? His arm gave out? You gotta be kidding me. This is a travesty, ladies and gentlemen, an absolute travesty. Yes! Oh, and a low blow. And look at that! Turnabout is fair play, ladies and gentlemen! Ichiban with a low blow of his own! And I gotta tell you, I don't care who knows it, I love to see it! These two now have dished out a world of punishment right now. Showing the intestinal fortitude, exchanging shots right in the middle of the ring. Who will come out on top? Who will get the better of this exchange? And right now, it looks like it's Ichiban. Fighting quite literally for his life here tonight. Another jumping knee strike right on the money. Big boot by the Underground King. No, once again, Ichiban out. And he got all of that, ladies and gentlemen. Rally in the crowd behind him. You hear those chants of one reverberate through Warehouse 635. He's setting him up for Ichiban Kai. Will he get it? He got all of it! Pin that man! One! Come on! Oh my God! I can't do this. Yes! Going for the Rana. No, once again caught by the Underground King. Powerbomb. Gets him up. No, come on. No, not like this. No, 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 no. No!
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner, and still, Test of Strength champion, and now, Test of Strength K1 Classic champion, the Underground!
Sick to my stomach right now. Nothing to say. I had no words. That man we see right there in the middle of the ring, by all accounts, should be our new Test of Strength heavyweight champion. An absolute travesty.
Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for the people's champion, Ichiban!
Ichiban! Ichiban! Ichiban! Ichiban! Ichiban!
Come on, man. We could do better than that. One more time for the best wrestler in the world, Ichiban. All right, I'm going to keep this short and sweet. I just want to thank everybody for coming out, for supporting us. I'm just as heartbroken as the rest of you, believe me. But there's a couple points that I want to make. In 2 weeks, on March 30th, our sister brand, our sister promotion, Legacy is Timeless, makes its Manchester, Connecticut debut. It is a joint venture with the Headlocks for Humanity Project. It is a program that is very near and dear to my heart. It is a charity that I, along with Doc Warren, the Break the Chains Foundation, put together as a fundraising program to raise funds for various issues in the community, whether it be untreated mental health, whether it be underfunded school programs, whatever it is our mission to come together and use the art of pro wrestling to amplify the lives of the children that we teach in this world. And I hope I get to see you all there. A lot of you have been with me on this journey. The last 2 years have been crazy for me, you know? 120 pounds and a whole head of hair later, I'm still standing thanks to every single one of you. To my baby girl, Cece, who couldn't make it, the GMS, I love you, mommy. You make the world go round. I'm super proud of you. Black belt, state champ, that's what we do, baby. Mama Frost, none of this is possible without you. I love you. Thank you for always having my back. Thank you to everybody who's here. I hope I get to see you guys on March 30th, where we set the stage to crown the first ever Legacy is Timeless champion. Ichiban will be there. Match number one, Ichiban, Ryan Fraust. Let's freaking go! I love y'all.